the Vulcans, the way the Vulcans are written in Enterprise continues to not make a tremendous amount of sense to me. And so when they throw them into a story like this, where they haven't fleshed out where the Vulcans' logic culture is starting, and it seems like they're fully engrossed in logic culture in an episode like this. It just seems that they have this weird hatred or stigma towards this disease, which doesn't really feel very Vulcan-y to me.
Right,
like
right.
That, and so when Archer's like, we humans have overcome this, you rotten Vulcan assholes haven't overcome it, it feels like a little bit of a flip-flop that they haven't really deserved.
Yeah, it feels sometimes like in this show, Vulcan ends up being a synonym for conservative or like Puritan, where they are, because of the way they act, because of the way they are traditionally kind of uptight.
Rigid, yeah, they're a rigid culture, yeah.
That kind of has gone through a bit of a telephone game down the years to mean that all Vulcans are like prudes or something, or just, you know, very puritanical in their belief systems and whatnot. when, I mean, in the original show, they don't really ever get into that stuff. I mean, they do have, what is it, Ponfar, where they get super hot and horny for like 8 days or whatever. But
oh, yeah.
Which, you know, so clearly they got
Brennan.
Some.
Brennan. Have you seen this Ponfar episode?
Brennan, has T'Pol gone through Ponfar yet? Is there a way we can work that into the show? Phlox's wife shows up and, oh my God, the Ponfar is just everywhere. And her name, can we call her MILF? Is it inappropriate if we just call her alien name is just MILF and we'll just spell it differently?
Put an umlauts on there.
Use a Y. But yeah, it seems like they're kind of doing that a little bit, where Vulcans are kind of being turned into this more puritanical conservative group, when that's not necessarily the way that they're meant to be portrayed. Because, yeah, the whole thing, I completely forgot about the only some people, some Vulcans know how to mind meld. It's like not something that's widely.
Do you remember the episode where the assault happened at all?
I only remembered it after they started talking. Okay. I completely forgot about it until they brought up, like, even when she said the thing about, you know, they started talking about the mind meld being kind of outlawed or whatever, I was like, oh, that's an interesting wrinkle for the Vulcans. And then they, as though I had never come across it.
Right.
And then once they started talking in the assault, I was like, oh, that's right. Because Archer's literally like turns to me in camera and is like, Clay, remember when she got assaulted by those guys on the ship? And I was like, thank you. Thank you, Jonathan. I do.
Yeah. I think it was called Fusion is the name of that episode where she met that feisty Vulcan who mind melded with her against her will. Yeah.
This episode, I mean, that episode really throws Spock into a pretty bad light in Star Trek VI, huh? I'm sure we talked about that at the time. I don't remember.
Oh, but, yeah, when he forces himself on to
Trump.
Yes. Whose name? I can't remember. Valeris or something. Is that? No, I can't remember. Anyway.
Sure.
Yeah, I think that they come around to acknowledging this and they retcon how this is supposed to work, I think. I think they're going to reconcile all this stuff, Enterprises. But before we get to that point, my point about the Vulcans is that they haven't done a very good job of setting up why they're different in this show. And the show thinks that they're different, or it seems to think that they're different. And everyone will give us the comments about like, just wait until season 4 when they explain why they've been different for the past 4 years. But it doesn't really fix the issue that they haven't done a good job of explaining why they're different now. So when you come into an episode like this where they are acting completely irrational, but they still have their emotionless culture where they just treat everything logically, it doesn't make a tremendous amount of sense. And I think your point about them just being conservatively rigid and the dads of space who are not letting the kids out to have any fun is, it's weird because I can kind of see why the Vulcans would be that way. I just don't think that the show has explained how they're different from the Vulcans that you know at this point, or where the divide is coming from that makes them act in ways that are not fitting with what you know of Spock and stuff like that later on.
Yeah. I know that they do try to explain stuff later, but I would be shocked if the explanation was there from the get-go. Like I don't know if they talk about this in that book at all, or either one of those books. But do you know, was there a conscious decision to write the Vulcans in a different way, or is it just like a game of telephone where what the Vulcans are ended up becoming something different, or the understanding of them ended up writer to writer to writer to series to series to series ended up just morphing?
No, I think there was intent to treat them differently, to have them be to have them be prototypical Vulcans. I think it's kind of a flawed idea because it's only 100 years until the Kirk Vulcans come along, so it's not really a very long time where they can change. I understand trying to treat them differently, but they're just not different, in my opinion.
Yeah, and I mean, also, Vulcans live for like 300
years. Right, so it would be the same guys you'd be seeing in the later episode.
I mean, hey, good on them to be able to make such a drastic change in their outlook in the later years of their life. That doesn't happen very often.
And it seems like the Vulcans would be the species that are able to do that, to turn around and be like, everyone, stop acting this way. We're just going to act in a different way and go forward with it. But
yeah,
I would have appreciated a little bit of difference
for everyone.